start with the next point in pointer, that is how to pass array, total array, to a function using pointer. Clear? Passing array. Passing array means we have to pass total array to a function. Okay, passing array to a function using pointer. Using pointer. Okay. So how to pass array to a function using pointer? Clear? Understand what is the point we have studied today? Okay. So first thing, we have to design function. We have to pass one argument to that function. That argument is a array, total array. We have to pass one total array to a function. Clear? Okay. So how to pass that array to a function using pointer? Next point is using pointer. Okay, so while catching that total array, we have to use pointer there. So first design one function. For example, now we can initialize one array. First we can initialize one array, integer array. Okay, pass that total array to a function. Suppose name of the function is the calculate average. Okay, array containing some elements 5, 10. We can make the addition of that, make the sum average of that, and we have to display that average. That is the work of that function. So what is the function name? Average. Okay, clear? So we can design first structure. How to design structure? Basic knowledge, that is previous knowledge, we have to design our function. Name of the function, what is the function name? That is average, is the function name. What is the argument? We have to write argument. What is the argument? We have to pass total array to a function. So how to pass array? We have to study now. Okay, next, what is the return type? Okay, average function doesn't return at anything to calling function. Clear? So return type is void. This is the name of the function. This is the name of argument list. So we have to decide how to pass the total array. So we can decide this. Okay, after that what? Curly bracket. Inside this average function, we have to display whatever may be the average of the elements in the array. That is the task of that average function. Clear? That average function does not return anything to the calling function. Is that clear? So this is a simple structure of average function. This is a structure. We have first designed the structure. Clear? Next point, we have to design main function. Previous that, what we have to include? Hash include stdio.h and conio.h header files. Clear? That is common. After that, we have to design void main. That is main function. Make the structure of the main function. This is the structure of main function. Clear? In that main function, what we have to do? First, in main function, we have to initialize one array. Declaration of the array is different from the initialization. Initialization means we have to assign values to the array. Clear? So we can take the array of 5 element, which is of type int. In name of the array, suppose a double r, that is the name of the array. Next, subscript operator, specify the size of the array. How many elements we have to store or initialize in the array? 5. So make the size as a 5, or it is optional. If you initialize the array, then it is optional, but if you declare the array, then it is compulsory. You have to specify the size. Okay, so we have to initialize one array having some element integer type 20, 10, 15, 5, again 12. These are the different elements. Okay, in that array. Clear? This is called as the initialization of the array elements. How many array elements we have to initialize? 5. That is static initialization. we have don't take the elements array element values from user at the runtime. If you take the values from user at the runtime, then it is called as the dynamic initialization of the array. Clear? Static initialization of the array and dynamic initialization of the array. Okay. So next point is, what is the next? What is our aim? We have to pass this total array from main function to the average function. We have to pass total array. Okay. After passing the total array to the average function, what is the work of the average function? Do the addition of all elements in the array, then make the average and display that average inside the body of average function. Clear? Clear the understanding? Okay. Doesn't return anything to the main function again. So return type is void. So our aim is the how to pass total array. Okay. So next one is, what is the next one? We have to call that average function. How to call the average function? Same name, average. If it is capital A, you can write here in capital. Okay. So next, what we have to pass? Total array, not single elements from the array. That is first element, that is at the index of array of 0, array of 1, array of 2, array of 4, 3, and array of 4. Okay, if you don't understand, just write memory management. Okay, at the time of explanation, what you require, while explaining that point, you have to draw RAM for understanding purpose. Okay, at the time of explanation, if you write whole program, after that explanation part, you have to write the explanation. Clear? So, what is the explanation? This is array. Okay, array of 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4. That is static initialization. So, first element is 10, 20, 15, 5, and 12. Okay, every location, that is block, one block of that array having 2 bytes. Okay, so first, suppose first address is 100, then second one is 102, 104, 106, and 108. These are the base addresses of that particular cell of that array. Clear? So first element array of 0 is at the address 100. Second element array of 1 is at the address 102. Clear? This is called as static memory management. It is done at the time of compilation. Okay, while you compile your program, then this memory management is happening. Clear? Okay, next part. Passing whole array to a function. So how we can pass the total array? Just use the name array. Okay. So just name of the array gives you base address. That is what we have to pass. Well, not by value, by reference. Array is passed by reference. That is by address. Clear? Because just name of the array gives you base address. That is we have to pass 100 actually. Clear? So we have to pass actual address of that array. So how we can catch it? For catching, we have to use pointer type of variable, because this is an address. Okay? When we pass any address, that is reference to a function, then for catching we use pointer type of variable. This is called as call by reference. That part we have already studied with one good example. Okay, call by value and call by reference. So we can pass reference address of the array. Okay, no need to write ampersand here, because name of the array itself is a base address of that array. Okay, otherwise there is one option, we can write it not like that, address of array, it is wrong. How we can write? Array of 0th element, that is base address of, again it is 100. Okay, it's worth, but no need, why to write it? Because name of array itself is a base address of that array. That is, we have to pass 100. Okay, for catching purpose, what we have to write here? Pointer type of variable. That is, we have to pass whole array to a function. Passing array to a function using pointer. Using pointer means we have used pointer for catching purpose. Okay, here how we can catch it? In pointer, give any name, suppose A. Means what? While this array at the runtime, when this function is called, function call get connected or bind from this line and jumps to this line. Okay, function call to its function definition. Okay, execution starts from there. At the runtime, in pointer A is equal to what? Array. Means what? Okay, here A is the pointer type of variable. A is not a simple variable, that is value variable. It is not value variable, it is a pointer type of variable. Two types of variables are there. Value variable, where we have to store actual value, and pointer variable, where we have to store address of the variable. Clear? So this is A. When this array is, that is equal to what? A double R array. Means what? In pointer A is initialized by address of the array. Initialized by the address of the array. So what is the meaning of that? Just while catching there, what is the A contains? 100, and 100 is now a pointer type of variable. So it points to this location. Clear the understanding? Clear the concept? So while passing the array, that array is catching here in the pointer type of variable. Okay, after that, clear? Next, now we have to make our logical part. This is a whole structure, just a structure. How we can pass total array to a function, and how we can catch here using pointer type of variable. Next point. What is the next point? How to make the summation of the elements in the array. Array elements exist in this, on this stack. Prior these elements are in the scope of main function. Okay, we have to access these elements from average function. Not directly, indirectly, using pointers. Okay, now what is our purpose? We have to access this value. Make the addition with the next element in that element, array. Next the addition with the third element, fourth element, fifth element, and make the summation. After that, divide by 5. It gives you average. That is simple one. So how to access first element of the array through this pointer? Okay, this is our target part. Okay, for that is equal to, take one variable, what? Sum. Declare here in average function, int sum is equal to initially 0. Okay, next part, just think, we have to access this first element 10 and make the addition with the sum variable. How we can access it? Using pointer A. Pointer A, what pointer A gives you? Value at that address location. What address stored in that pointer? 100. What is the value at that 100 location? 10. So this gives you value at that address location. That is first element's value. That is 10. Okay. We can simply add with the sum and store the result, total result, into sum variable. Use the semicolon. Statement ends. Okay. What is the next decision point? Same statement, we have to run how many times? 5 times. That is, we have to use loops. Clear? Same statement, we have to use multiple times. That is, we have to use loops. So again, use loops. How many times we have want to execute it? I is equal to 1. I less than equal to 5. I plus plus. For loop, curve,
5.
Starts from 1. Okay, it is not a index. We cannot access index. If we want to access index of the array, then array initialization I initialize to 0. We want only how many times this statement executes. You can start it from 100, no problem. 100 to 105, no doubt. Okay, clear. Initialize the variable int I. Declare it. Understand what I have to mean? Okay, sum is equal to sum plus a pointer a, or you can use bracket. No need, but for your understanding purpose. Means what? Pointer a. Now where a points first element. So it takes the value 10, add with the first iteration, that is 0. 0 plus 10, what is the sum? 10, and stored into sum variable. Next, what happens? I plus plus, that is 2. I becomes 2. Okay, just I initial value is now 1. Second, sum. Now initial value of sum becomes 10. First iteration, after first. Now I plus plus becomes 2. 2 less than equal to 5 condition, true. Again sum, what is the sum now? 10, take the value from the RAM, plus a pointer a, again 10. So here some logic requires. What is our next step? We have to increment that pointer to the next location. Okay, we have to increment it. So what is the statement? A plus plus, simply. That part we have to study in previous lecture. Okay, so what is the part? A plus plus here. One statement remaining. We have to add it. A plus plus. What is the meaning of A plus plus? Is equal to A is equal to A plus 1. Means what? Address is incremented by one location. Okay, this is an array location. So it increment by 2. Integer array. So it increment by 2. If it is character, it increment by 1. Clear? So we can increment the pointers, but we cannot add 2 pointers. If there are 2 pointers, we cannot add 2 pointers. But 1 pointer we can increment by 1. We can increment by 2 or 10. No doubt. But pointer stores the address of array. Is it possible? But where is it possible? When the array, that pointer stores the address of array element, then only we can increment it. Otherwise, 2 pointers cannot be added. Okay, that is arithmetic operation on pointers. That part also we have to study in previous lecture. Clear? So A plus plus. So what is A plus plus means? First, A plus plus means after summation, what happens? A plus plus means A is incremented by 1. That which points to address location 102. Next is the I plus plus, it becomes true, 2 less than equal to 5, means condition true. After that, next statement sum, sum is equal to 10 plus, what is the value at that address location? Now address location is 102, so value at that address location is 20, so 20, that is 30, where that 30 is stored into sum variable. So now value of the sum is becomes 30. Next point, after this statement, what's A plus plus? What is that? X plus plus, increment address of A by 2, that is 4. So this pointer points to 104 location, where value is 15. Now next, I plus plus, that is 3 less than equal to 5, condition true, come inside the loop, body of loop, sum. Now sum becomes 30 plus 15, it becomes 45. Again A plus plus, that is pointer is incremented by 1, next location is 106. Again I plus plus, that is 4 less than 5, condition true. Again sum is equal to now 45 plus 5, it becomes 50, stored into sum. A plus plus, that is now 12. Okay, next 50, condition true, 5 less than equal to 5, condition true. Next, what happens? 50 plus 12, that is 62, stored into sum variable. And again A plus plus means now it points to the next location, that is 110. Okay, but what happens? I becomes now 6. So loop terminated. After that, what happens? We can add every element that in that array. We have to add every element into that array, okay, and store the result into some variable. Now we can make average. So how to calculate average? Sum divided by how many numbers? 5. So it is ABG, that is name of the variable, not the same as that of the function, okay, and then declare it as a ABG. So whatever may be the average of 62 divided by 5, okay, so what is the average? Hmm. 12. Okay, 12, integer part only, not float, because average is the integer part. So whatever may be the integer part, that only save in the average variable, and then printf average is equal to percentage %d double quotes complete, abg function complete. Okay, that's over. That means we have to pass total array to a function using pointer. Using pointer, we cannot pass array. Actually, what we have to pass? Base address of the array. Through that base address, we can access each and every location of the array, make the addition, and display the result. Clear? So we will stop here.